In December 2019, I had the opportunity to visit the new Nickelodeon Universe theme park at the American Dream Mall in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is right across from New York City. It's this massive complex that includes indoor skiing, a DreamWorks water park, ice rink, and tons of shopping. However, unfortunately, most of that is not open yet. And that goes for not just the mall, but also Nickelodeon Universe as well. So in this video, I want to discuss my experience at Nickelodeon Universe and the mall as a whole, so you can know whether or not you should visit. So a few things that I want to talk about. The first being that I visited this park about 2 months after it had opened. And when the place opened, not all of the rides were operating. And you know, I'll cut them some slack for that. I get it. I see how things were, but you know, I said, okay, I'll give them 2 months. They'll get their stuff together, and I think that'll be a good time to visit. Well, boy, was I wrong. 2 months later, and man, there are still lots of rides that are not open. At least they weren't open when I was there. I was told they try to get everything open on weekends if they can, because that's when it's busier. But because they're open every day, on weekdays, like the day that I went when it was virtually deserted, they said, well, we're just not gonna have everything open. So I got to ride 3 of the 5 roller coasters. Sandy's Blasting Bronco is still not open, by the way. Shredder was also closed while we were there. And here's something fun. The day we were originally gonna go to Nickelodeon Universe, Shellraiser was down. And it was also down the day we went. The difference is we decided to do the Twilight ticket access, which allows you to get into the park for a cheaper price 3 hours before they close. And luckily by then, on the second day, they had managed to get Shellraiser open, so we were able to ride it. However, if we only had the day we were originally gonna go, we wouldn't have even been able to ride that. So I'm glad that luckily we had budgeted in time where we could say, okay, let's try again tomorrow. And luckily they were able to open everything. But I think that that is just like a slap in the face. Like, yikes, your major coaster wasn't even open. And that's on top of the drop tower not operating. Shredder was down and stayed closed. We did get to see it testing, but it did not open. And granted, I will say they do have an alert on their website that when you go in, like you're gonna buy tickets online in advance, they'll tell you what rides are not operating. And when you physically get to the mall in person, there is a sign at the ticket counter that says what is open and what is not. So it's not like you're blindly going in, not knowing what will be open and what will be closed. You should have some sort of heads up. And they told us that they update the website as often as they can to tell you what is actually operating. So the biggest piece of advice I can get before you come here is check the website, see the alert, and you'll be able to find out what is operating that day. But because I think they've been having some issues getting all the rides open, and the fact that so many of the other attractions in the mall are not open, this place was deserted. There was no one here. We were some of the only guests in the entire park, in a mall that is not fully operational. And so it was just kind of a weird atmosphere. My logic with that is that I think everyone else saw that so many rides weren't open and said, well, we're not gonna go until everything's operating. And frankly, I don't blame them. On top of the fact that this park is a little bit of a hassle to get to. Yeah, the mall is hooked into the New Jersey transit system. Because the entire mall is not done yet, everything outside of the mall is a construction site. You have to wind basically around the entire mall through construction cones, trying to find a place to park. And then once you actually get in the mall, you're allowed to walk through most of it, but a lot of it is just construction areas. I think it's gonna be really nice once it's all done, but as of right now, it's just a very strange feeling. When most stores aren't open, the only thing that's open is Nickelodeon Universe and Big Snow, and a few occasional food carts. But the water park got delayed, so that wasn't operating, even though it looked pretty much done while we were there. But the good news is that most of the hallways were done, and man, they were brand spanking new, shiny. The aesthetic is really good. It's gonna be a really high class mall when it's done. So for that reason, I am really excited to see how everything turns out once everything's operating. But the state of American Dream right now is not really that great. And I think they know that. I mean, there's no way that they're turning a profit at this point. They're gonna have to have everything open for a while to really start making some real money. But anyways, let's talk about the park as a whole. So this is a pay one price ticket. It is not pay per attraction. So you cannot just walk in the park and just pay for the specific rides you want to do. You have to get a wristband. And they do have a specific area where they'll scan your wristband, and then you're allowed to pass to go down the escalators into the park. There is a viewing deck. So if you don't want to pay to enter the park, but you just want to watch watch, there is an area where you can do that. But that's just one of the first things, because if you go to someplace like Galaxyland at the West Edmonton Mall, which I've been to, anyone can just walk in the park, but you pay per ride. So this is a different ticketing system, which I thought was interesting. I can see the pros and the cons with doing it that way, but just more so surprised me that they didn't make it the same system as like what Galaxyland has. Now I want to talk about the actual atmosphere in the park. And I'm not just talking about how some of the rides are open and some are not. One thing the park does well is having each of the attractions themed to the different characters that you'll find in Nickelodeon shows. You'll find SpongeBob themed attractions, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Fairly Odd Parents, Legends of the Hidden Temple, all sorts of stuff. And it's all just kind of jumbled together. There's no cohesive area where it's like, all right, this is the SpongeBob area. This is the Mutant Ninja Turtles area. No, they're all just kind of mixed in together, which I think is fine. Personally, that doesn't bother me. But as a result, you don't have really one cohesive theme throughout the park. Like, you don't have any specific areas around the attractions theme to a show. Each individual ride has its own theme, and it's not immersive by any means. I think they have a good aesthetic going. Like, for instance, I want to talk about their wave swinger. This is themed to a jellyfish from SpongeBob. This is probably the best wave swinger I've ever seen. The theming is really cool, what they managed to do with this thing. I think it looks fantastic. But then you get something like Jimmy Neutron's Atom Smasher, where the actual ride has nothing to do with the Jimmy Neutron theme. They've made little to no attempt to tie it into the actual show. It's a flat ride with the name attached, and that's all you get. So I think some of the rides, the theming, it's a bit of a stretch. Even Sandy's Blasting Bronco, I'm like, what kind of a theme is that? But I guess at the end of the day, I would call this more of an amusement park over a theme park, even though, yeah, it has the theme of Nickelodeon. By no means is this park immersive, and I don't think they're necessarily trying to be. It's what I guess I'd call casual theming. I think theming the ropes course to Legends of the Hidden Temple was a brilliant idea. And let me just say, that is a fantastic ropes course. I cannot recommend that enough. It's not an upcharge or anything, but definitely do it. For one, the view from the top is spectacular. But two, some of these things are pretty challenging. And you're completely hooked in there, so you're 100% safe. But man, it is cool, and you'll get a workout. I mean, this is a pretty tall attraction, so I absolutely recommend that. But one of the downsides with, I think, Nickelodeon Universe is it feels like the entire park is just in a box. You can see the plain gray unthemed walls on one side. They have some areas that are decorated, but a lot of empty space where it just feels hollow. Almost like the park lacks personality, which is weird because, you know, with all of the different theming with the specific rides, it's easy to think, oh, they're giving the park personality. But something about it, it felt like it almost lacked charm. It felt corporate. The park feels like it's in a warehouse. Like, you could plop this entire thing down in the middle of a Costco and it would feel the exact same. I have not been to Nickelodeon Universe at the Mall of America in Minnesota, but I've been told that that park does not have the same feeling. I have been to Galaxyland though, however, and I would say that that one doesn't feel as much like a park in a box. It has lots of cheesy theming, but I'd say it felt more like a fun classic park than this. So I just thought that was interesting. And that's not to say that this is a bad park, because I do think they do lots of things well. I like how they have lots of the different statues of certain characters outside of attractions. Like, they have an Aang character on Appa outside of his ride. There's a Squidward at the bus stop. They'll have the Mutant Ninja Turtles. One of them has a pizza in his hand. The other's on a skateboard. There's a Timmy Turner, Patrick and a Rocket, like all sorts of stuff. So in that regard, I think it's great. So I think they nailed that aspect of it. I love all the different characters that they have represented in the park, and they even have walk-around characters. While we were there, we saw the Ninja Turtles, we saw SpongeBob and Patrick. All that is great. But I think to just kind of wrap things up, this park is still finding its footing. I'd be very interested in see how this place is in a few years, or even 1 year. I think it'll find its place. They'll figure out how to really perfect everything, and maybe they'll go ahead and paint or theme this wall so it feels less like a just giant industrial box. I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if they are not done with this place and they still have things that they want to do. So the biggest piece of advice I can give for this park is don't go yet. I think it is a good idea to wait to visit here. Even though they have several new roller coasters and they look really cool. Maybe if you're visiting New York City, yeah, I mean, go ahead and go if you're in the area. But I think if you're thinking about making a visit to this part of the country specifically to go here, don't do it yet. I think it would be best to wait until everything is open. And that includes the water park and the rest of the mall, because Nickelodeon Universe as a whole is not a very big park. We had 3 hours there. I thought that was just enough time to do everything, and we were fine. I've heard people have spent 1 hour here, and then they're bored, and then they're done. So if you wait, then you can turn it into a full day experience with the water park, the indoor skiing and snowboarding, the mall. And I imagine you'll have a pretty good experience. So that's my recommendation. I recommend the park, but also I don't. Just wait a few months, maybe even a year. Give them time to figure everything out. And then I think you'll have a pretty solid park. So those are my thoughts on Nickelodeon Universe at the American Dream Mall in New Jersey. Let me know down in the comments below if you've had the chance to visit here, if you agree with what I said, and also let me know if this review helped you. But of course, you can stay tuned for more park reviews here at Coaster Studios. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.